I think that this is the time to trade away Terry McLaurin. Yes, I understand that Kyle Allen has now taken over as the starting quarterback for the Washington football team, which kind of raises some concern on Terry McLaurin's performance. Terry McLaurin has been very like, meh, all season, right? He had a better game this week against the Giants than he did in week 5 and that game against the Rams, because the Rams defense just absolutely tore through the Washington football team. But the reason why I think you could trade him away and look to get some potential value back in return is because of the schedule for the Washington football team. They go up against the Cowboys, which defense we understand has been abysmal all season. Then they have a bye week. Then they go back up against the Giants. Then they take on the Lions and then the Bengals. If you look at all of those teams aren't great against wide receivers, which is why I think if a fantasy manager is stretched at the wide receiver position, you could get some potential value back in return.
Yeah, I definitely see that coming. I think that's a good reason. I would say that that's a reason maybe I'm trying to trade for him if I'm shorthanded at wide receiver, just because of that schedule. So I think in some ways we're sort of in concert on this one. So I think we're sort of looking at this the same way. And I think it just depends on what your roster situation is. Because if I need a wide receiver, I'm going to try and see if I can get Terry McLaurin on the low because of those games you mentioned, the Giants, the Cowboys, the Giants again, the Lions, the Bengals. The schedule coming up is pretty favorable. So I think we're sort of coming at this from different angles of the same, we're getting different pieces of the same pie, right? Like, I think we're talking about this sort of the same way. But I do think Terry McLaurin is going to be kind of an interesting trade chip. So if there's somebody in your league who's nervous about having him because of the Kyle Allen situation, then I think you go out and make an offer and see if you can get Terry McLaurin at sort of a discounted value, because at least in the short term, the schedule is very favorable. And I think he's worth having on your roster as long as they can, get some quality targets there. So, hey, I think you're onto something, Kimmy. I'm taking notes.
Maybe I'll make my very first trade. Maybe this is it. You've convinced me.
Next up is Brandon Cooks, who the last couple of weeks has been very good. He had kind of been missing in action for a little bit, but he's been very good. Now, I will throw in a little bit of added spice to this by saying there is some talk that the Texans could maybe try and move on from Brandon Cooks, that when we get closer to the trade deadline, they might try to move him. Who knows what sort of situation he ends up in after that. Are you trading for him? Would you rather trade for him or would you rather trade him away at this point?
I think especially dependent on that news, I'm going to trade away and see what I can get back in return. So yes, he's had 2 consecutive games with a touchdown and over 20 fantasy points. So this may be the moment where, again, if fantasy managers are looking for a wide receiver and they don't have a lot of depth at that position, this is where you can get some potential, value out of Brandon Cooks, because these could be his ceiling games. I think if he stays with the Houston Texans, I have my bets on Will Fuller of being that number one receiver for the team and just the connection that Deshaun Watson and him have had all season. But this is very good for Brandon Cooks and those fantasy managers who have him, because you can absolutely upplay his last 2 weeks of performances and get a trade that you feel like you won in the end. If that makes any type of sense.
It does make sense. And I'm with you. I think I'm trying to trade away Brandon Cooks. After what we've seen the past couple of weeks, I feel like his ceiling, his value may be up about as much as it can get here, because this is, I agree, still an offense that primarily is going to target Will Fuller. I also don't like the uncertainty of maybe he gets traded somewhere else, because who knows where that somewhere is going to be, if that is going to maybe torpedo his fantasy production or what have you. So I think this is a situation where I'm going to try and move Brandon Cooks and see what I can get for him at this point, because I just don't know if it's going to get much better than this. I like him. He just is so volatile week to week that it's hard to count on him. And so I want to try and get as much as I can out of him right now. And this might be the time to do it. All right. So one last one, a young wide receiver who maybe isn't quite as heralded. And that's Tim Patrick with the Denver Broncos. And I know our own Adam Rank has been on the Tim Patrick train for a couple of weeks now, and he's played very well, maybe kind of quietly, because when we talk about the Denver Broncos, people talk about Jerry Jeudy, but Tim Patrick stepped up. Is this a time to maybe try to go get him, or are you trying to deal him when the or strike while the iron's hot and try to make a deal for Tim Patrick? trade him away.
I feel like on this one, and again, I'm a trade chicken, so I could be completely wrong. I'm always going to preface this with that. I am looking to kind of trade for Tim Patrick and see what and see if I can get someone to give him to me and I stash him on my squad. Because now that Drew Lock has returned at quarterback position, he surpassed 100 receiving yards. Yes, Jerry Jeudy is a wide receiver one right now, but you also have to realize Jerry Jeudy has had some drops. And he has been in some situations and some scenarios where he has very catchable balls and he's not been able to deliver. That's when you then see the offense turn away from Jerry Jeudy and instead go to Tim Patrick. Now, this is a really quiet name and kind of a deeper name in the fantasy world, but I absolutely think he's someone who is relevant. Now, Noah Fant, the tight end, he's still out with an injury. Once he comes back, I do see them using him as a receiving option, kind of very similar to the way that George Kittle is used in the San Francisco offense. However, I still think that Tim Patrick is going to get production and be relevant. So if I can, I'm going to look to trade and see if I can get Tim Patrick on my team.
100% agree. I think I'm trading for Tim Patrick. He's had 100 yards receiving in back-to-back games. He's had touchdowns in two of his last three games. And there are some games on the schedule where the Broncos are going to have to throw the football to stay in them. They've got the Chiefs coming up next week. They've got the Chargers. And then some games that the matchups work out well, whether it's against the Raiders, against the Falcons. So there are some reasons to think that the arrow is trending up on Tim Patrick, and maybe you can sort of snake him from somebody in your league who isn't necessarily paying close attention. Look, there's a very good chance that in a lot of leagues, he's still on the waiver wire, which is also sort of a hint, hey, maybe go get Tim Patrick if he's out there because he's playing really well. But if there's somebody in your league that has him, maybe this is the time to see if you can get him as part of a package in a deal. So see, Kimmy, you might be a trade chicken, but you're good at this. I'm learning.
I'm a trade chicken who's smart. I got it. Maybe today is finally the day. Once we wrap, I'm gonna go look at my squad and start trading away and trading for everybody.
I will say this, and this is sort of a general PSA, because I feel like there are a lot of people out there who play fantasy who are probably trade chickens, and it's understandable. Nobody wants to feel like they got ripped off in a trade. Nobody wants to feel like they gave up a good player and didn't get anything back in return. So maybe one of these days we'll find a way to do a show to kind of give you the basics on what to look for and what to think about when you're making a trade. Because I suspect that a lot of reasons people don't make trades is because they are afraid of maybe making that mistake. And it's not always the case. That it's not as difficult as you think it might be.